Willie it is to start to Quinton Lecoq.
No!
Drags it on. Look at a throw for England, and that's the ideal start for David Willie.
Yeah, big wicket. Such a destructive batter is Quinton Lecoq afterwards if he gets in. So it's a big wicket for England and a slightly soft and tame end for Quinton Lecoq, who just drags a fairly innocuous.
This could be close, big appeal. Not given. Are they going to go upstairs? There's a bit of discussion already. This would be unbelievable for David Willie.
You can make your decision now, you're on screen.
So good decision in the end, going over the top. No second wicket for England, but still a wow over that. Inside edge, that could be the first boundary of the day and will be a fortunate one for Hendricks.
With regularity, and he won't far away from another one here.
It has been the success of Tuckley and Willie at the top of the order has really been key for England throughout the one days. And not an over. It's a shot that picked him up a boundary and got him into trouble in the first T20, but Riley Rousseau deals with that nicely. So a boundary to India over two done, 9-1. Another fortunate boundary, second one of the day for Reza Hendricks. That delivery swung nicely.
Late movement back in from Willie. The seam perfectly positioned to help the ball to come back in. And because fine leg, Adil Rashid is up inside the circle, he gets a boundary.
That's beautifully played. That wasn't a short arm jab, there was a genuine drag down onto it in a flash. That's better from Reza Hendricks. I think with the trajectory that it's gone out into that outfield, it might be cut off. Races on, and it wins it. That was a bit of a teaser to end the over. The fourth over done, 28-1. Hopefully the players and the umpires can hold the nerve, who can stay on. Top edge, and that's another fortunate boundary. Third one of the day for Hendricks. I think it actually made contact with his shoulder as it made its way over Josh Butler.
Well, that's very, very delicately, cleverly played. We are used to the power and thunder of Riley Rousseau, but as he showed in Cardiff and has just shown there, he's got a deft touch as well. Lucky. And it's gone away for four. Moral victory for Jordan, but he's under pressure straight away. His first three balls have gone for nine.
Through the leg side, and Rousseau's still looking to access the offside. Here we see it again. Jordan goes fuller. Rousseau continues his fine touch.
Offside again, and that's powered to the fence. That's 17 from the final over of the power play. South Africa's 50 comes up, 53-1.
Yeah, Moe!
What an absolute ripper from Moeen Ali. The matchup was there. Butler wanted him bowling at Riley Rousseau, who's in such good form. And Moeen Ali has produced something spectacular.
And Josh Butler, absolute beauty from Moeen Ali. Nothing Riley Rousseau can do about that.
Short from Jordan, and that has been banged into the gap in the wide open spaces between mid-on and mid-wicket, and that will be the first boundary for South Africa since the power play.
Probably a little bit more pace on it than what we saw from Curran. He's absolutely middled that, and they're also starting to get the understanding for the tactics that have been used and what needs to be done. You can see how he even...
to hedge end, the Ageas Bowl. Final over for Rashid, and that is a magnificent piece of placement and timing for Reza Hendricks. Swept hard and square, that's a magnificent stroke. Aidan Markram starting to motor.
This is what he learned a lot and was able to do at the RPL. That's hit with real power right off the middle.
Reza Hendricks gets back for the second. There's a cheer from the crowd. But even if he doesn't get back for two, that'll be A third consecutive 50 for Hendricks.
Okay, I'm ready with my decision for the big screen.
Pretty straightforward call. Reza Hendricks is not out. He moves to 51.
As he has in these three games. And that's beautifully played as well. Might be a bit of a pitching wedge, so stops. No, it doesn't. It bounces on nicely. So it brings up a boundary for him as well.
To the leg side now.
Just about there as he helps it over the leg side. And the umpires will take a long look at this. We've seen a few of those actually today from Reza Hendricks. I think of his first four boundaries. Hit very firmly into the leg side. If the earlier boundary had an element of good fortune about it. Slower ball and should be taken by Joss Butler, who just steadies himself and does well. Excellent slower ball from Chris Jordan, just 71 miles an hour.
From Chris Jordan, previous two deliveries, pace on balls. And Yorkers chooses to pull his length back. Excellent catch from Joss Butler.
Oh, cute, beautiful, really good from Markram. And whips it behind square. This is very inventive batting from Aidan Markram. Sweetly struck for South Africa's first six of the afternoon. It's a measure of how big the boundaries are here at the Rose Bowl. That is our first one midway through the 19th over.
Miller gets great contact on it. Holds his shape. Hits it a long, long way.
This is really good from Miller. Just six balls and he's 19, striking at over 300. Hit firmly down the ground by Markram. Should come back for a couple. And that brings up his half century. Strike rate of around about 140, which is very standard for him in T20 cricket. 51, we've got one over left, 181 for three. Very good from David Willey, who's having an enjoyable afternoon here at the Rose Bowl. Picks up his second wicket.
Staying very, very straight, trying to tuck David Miller up. Just clips the leg stump.
In the air it goes. Oh, brilliantly taken. Liam Livingston is out at cover. He had to make some ground away to his right and takes a very good catch low down.
Probably gets away first ball. It's all on Polly. All to play for. Oh, there's nobody there. Now that will get you going. Jason Roy picks up five, and maybe his luck has changed. Maharaj hangs his head and says sorry. Clipped away, there's nobody there. Ngidi replaces Maharaj, and Butler finds the boundary.
Oh!
Edged. It's going to run away for four. I wonder if that ball might have missed leg stump. Oh, in the air, yeah! And taken. Once again, Joss Butler unable to get going. Unable to see his side through the power play. But South Africa do not care.
I think this is a massive moment in the game. We've seen Butler start brilliantly in all three of the T20 internationals, but hasn't really been able to go on and get a really big score. It's the case in point again today, 14 from 10.
Pace on through, big appeal, finger goes up, and it's that slow walk off again for Jason Roy.
At just over 90 miles an hour, a fastball short. Roy looking to belt it down the ground, flat bat style. And the top edge through to Quinton de Kock.
Milan goes into the leg side, bigger boundaries, very good catch. It's Norkia lurking out there behind square on the leg side. Milan looking for that big shot, targeting Petlaquayo.
Which was really poor in the opening game at Bristol, much better in Cardiff. And the first catch taken safely by Norkia.
Chipped. Oh, what a spectacular catch. He's some cricketer, this Tristan Stubbs. That is breathtakingly good.
To take this mid-air in his left hand, fantastic. Bit of a leading edge from Moeen Ali, and he was off Stubbs. Brilliant, absolutely brilliant. That is the moment of the match so far.
Up and over, but he hasn't cleared. It's straight to Maharaj, it's another one. Shamsi tossing that one up into the air, just 50 miles per hour, the slowest delivery of the day, and it's worked the trick.
Liam Livingston looking to take the attack to him. England needed to do something. Not getting any of it. Simple catch taken by Maharaj.
Shamsi continues. Sam Curran goes up and he gets the first maximum of the England innings. So all of a sudden there's been a little bit of a shift. Riley Rousseau heading in the wrong direction and Sam Curran heading in the right direction.
Not that bad a ball from Shamsi, picked up by Sam Curran.
Up, and this time he picks out a fielder. It's another comfortable catch. I think it could be Aidan Markram this time. So the brief enjoyment for the English fans has now gone.
There's only one way to play at the moment, the rate of above 17 runs and over required. Sam Curran looking for the maximum again, can't find the boundary.
Gets the crease in his position. Yeah! That's a wicket. Tries to take the attack to Shamsi on the first delivery. Shamsi's off in the Imran Tahir celebration. Back-to-back wickets, seven down for England.
Aggression from the first delivery from Willie, the top spinner online. Willie looks to sweep and gets nothing on it.
And no such luck for Shamsi. He's done a really good job, but Jordan equal to the task, just nudging it down the ground. As the choir continues, and this could be close as well. No, it's not given. And the angle, it looked pretty good, but maybe being a judge just heading down the leg side.
You're on screen signal now.
David Miller was on the deep mid-wicket boundary, so...
Yeah! Shamsi likes it. He didn't even look at the umpire, actually. It was almost just a celeb appeal as he ran through to the wicketkeeper. Jordan has reviewed. Shamsi thinks he's got his man.
Great, he's been forced. Yeah! He's asked batters to... make contact, really.
Yeah, if we can go to ball tracking, please. Pitching in line, impact in line. Wickets is umpire's call. With your original decision of out, you're on screen now.
Oh, well. For Tabrez Shamsi, great delight for him. This left arm wrist spinner who fizzes it one way and then the other is picking up wickets for fun here at the Ageas Bowl.
Can't tell you how difficult an evening he had at Bristol. Couldn't keep the ball in the park while he was bowling, but since then he has come back like a champion. He's number two.
This could be the end. It is. South Africa have been absolutely dominant. Well, it needed a miracle, didn't it, from Bairstow, who just couldn't really get going as wickets tumbled around him this evening. This was the final moment with Miller settling himself under the skyer. He's been good tonight. He came in and just gave the innings impetus.